Hey viewers, welcome to Super Duper Kitchen. So today we are going to see the recipe for chepangaranga roast. Chepangaranga is called as taro in English. So taro is a root vegetable and the plant is called as colocasia. So this is one of the most popular vegetable in South India and people make sambar and curry with this. So this particular recipe is even made during wedding and it is very tasty. So now let's see how to make this recipe. So to make this, I have taken required quantity of taro. So we have to wash it well. So to remove the dirt and transfer it into a kadai, and we are going to cook this taro until it is 3/4 done. So we can also cut this taro into half if it is so big and we can cook it. So once it starts cooking, the skin is automatically come out. So in between I have just chopped the taro into half, but you can also cook it as a whole. So when you insert a knife on the taro, it will pierce easily inside. So now it's done. At this stage we can remove this taro and drain the water. So we can also wash this with cold water so that it becomes cool, quick cool down, and it will be easy for us to peel off the skin. So if you are not able to peel off the skin when it is hot, you just allow it to sit for 15 to 20 minutes, then you can peel off the skin. So after peeling off, we can either chop this taro like a disc or a slice, or we can cut it into small pieces. It is according to our taste. In whatever way we like, we can just chop it into that shape. So here I am going to chop it into small pieces so that it gets roasted well. So do the same thing with remaining taro and then add 4 teaspoons of coconut oil into the kadai. Since we are going to make the roast, we need to add more oil so that you get the pakka roasted texture. Then splatter mustard seeds. And another important point is you can also splatter mustard seeds at the end so that it will not turn black. So, but I prefer to add in the beginning. Then add the chopped taro and mix well. Coat it well with the coconut oil. Once it is coated well with the coconut oil, we can add all the spices. So here I am going to add 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 2 teaspoons of red chili powder, required amount of salt for this recipe. So you can also add red chili powder more if you want it more spicy. So I have added 2 teaspoons, which is sufficient for us. And if you are going to give it to the kids, then you can just add 1 teaspoon of red chili powder and mix it well. They get roasted really well. And to get the good texture, finally we will be adding 2 tablespoons of rice powder. So this gives the nice crispiness for this palya or dry sabzi. So I learned this recipe from my perima and she gave me this useful tip. By adding rice powder, we can get a good texture for this curry. So it goes well with a sambar sadam, rice sadam, rasam sadam, or even puliyodarai. It is really yummy. So now the palya is ready. You can serve it with any rice of your choice. So do try this chepangaranga roast at home and give me your feedback. See you all in another recipe. Until then, it's bye from Niranjana Shankar Narayanan. Thank you one and all.